podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learning Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1558, Paste to Merge Cells. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question sent in from the Netherlands. Oh, this is a tough one. He has 100 merged cells, right? Now, right here, I only have 5, but they're different sizes, anywhere from 2 cells to 6 cells. And he has the 100 values that he wants to be able to copy and then paste into those merged cells. Well, that just is not going to work. I tried a lot of different things. If you just do a Ctrl+V, it's going to unmerge, right? So, no, we definitely don't want to do that. I said, all right, what if we copy and then select the constants only. So Ctrl+G for go to special, choose the constants, click OK. Now I've selected in theory only those 5 cells. I will try a paste, paste special values. I even tried skip blanks, but that goes the other way. That gets rid of the blanks over here, not the blanks over here. And it's just destroying the data. I even tried turning everything sideways and using center across selection instead of merge cells, and that just didn't work. All right, so here is the solution that I came up with. We're going to select the 5 cells here, or in this case 100 cells, and we're going to select only the constants again. So Ctrl+G, special, constants. So now I only have 5 cells selected. Then a formula equal index of this range over here, press F4, and I want to grab the successive value. So I'm going to count, actually count A, in case some of this is text. Well, it is text. The count A of $1 to D1. All right, that's one of those cool expanding ranges. Close the other parenthesis, and then I'm going to Ctrl+Enter to enter that similar formula in all of the cells that have values. All right, now when I initially did this, I got a big circular reference warning and all zero. So in order to make it work, all right, I guess I'm doing a circular reference on purpose here, because I'm counting and the count includes the cells that I'm filling in. We want to go to File. You can't see it just off your screen, Options, and then Formulas, and turn on Enable Iterative Calculation. That really should say, hey, I'm using circular references and I'm okay with that. And then click OK, and then this starts to work. Let me just show you, if we go into Excel Options and Formulas, and that's unchecked. All right, then we get a circular reference warning, and when you initially enter these, they all show up as zeros. So that kind of shut me down until I said, oh wait, let's turn on the circular reference. And sure enough, it started to work. There you go. And then of course, if you had more data that you wanted to copy and paste, well now it's simple. All right, so you have some cells here. Now let's just do F, G, H, and that. So now we take those cells, copy them, paste to this, let's call it a helper column, and the merge cells will pick up that value. So not an exact copy and paste. Again, this is another reason why people say, oh, don't use merge cells, because they're just evil. Well, in this case, you know, there might be a good valid reason why they needed to do that, although it certainly becomes much more of a hassle. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast. Mr. Excel.